What high-paying tech jobs don't require any code? Ever since joining Amazon, I've realized that there are so many high-paying tech jobs that do not require any coding. What are these five jobs? I'll be talking about the role, the skills, qualifications, and pay. The first on the list is a UX designer. Imagine you're building a banking app and you want to ensure that it is user-friendly and functional. The UX designer will research the user's needs and then they will map out the navigation flow of the app and prototype the app to make sure that it is user-friendly. Key skills that a UX designer has is design tool skills, as in they know how to use Sketch or Adobe XD. They also have strong design knowledge as well as really strong communication skills. A UX designer doesn't need to know any code, but they should have a knowledge of how websites are built and technology in order to be able to know which parts of the design are more technically complex to build. As for qualifications, a UX designer does not have a specific degree requirement, but you will see people commonly with psychology or sociology degrees because you have to really understand people's minds and how they think. And a portfolio is often used in these roles in order to showcase your design skills to get your first UX designer job. For salary, UX designers can expect around $92,000 to $156,000 on Glassdoor. I did cross-check this list against Indeed, where I saw around $126,000, and on Levels, I did see $156,000, so I think that's a pretty accurate range to expect. Next on the list who work alongside UX designers are product managers, and they are also the voice of the customer. In the same example of building a new app, the product manager will set the vision for the team. They will prioritize the different tasks. They'll also have to collaborate with different technical teams, as well as track the key metrics for success for the product. Some key skills are data analytics to track the key metrics, as well as strategic thinking and leadership, because you have to really push your team towards a common goal. And while product managers don't need to specifically code, they do need to have a strong technical knowledge in order to be able to communicate with the different technical teams like the software engineers and the data teams. There isn't a specific degree requirement, but I have seen a lot of technical people such as software engineers and data people transition into product roles, as well as non-technical people who also land product manager jobs. Most times, people gain some domain knowledge and kind of work their way into this role. As for salary, you can expect around $120,000 to $205,000. And on Levels for more senior roles, you can see the salary goes up to $280,000. I will say from my personal experience, this job tends to be a little more high stress. So definitely factor that in with the salary. Similar to a product manager, the next on our list is a project manager, and their role revolves around the project. The project manager will project plan, assemble the right teams, and manage the stakeholders. Personally, having worked with project managers, I would say that they spend a lot of their time influencing others, so they have really strong communication skills, time management, and project planning management skills such as Scrum and Agile. While project managers don't have to actually code, they do have to have a strong technical knowledge in order to be able to communicate with technical teams and be able to know how to build out a technical project. As for qualifications, there is no specific degree requirement for project managers. I've seen a lot of software engineers or other non-technical people land project manager roles, and certifications really help here if you want to land your first project manager role, and those include a PMP as well as being Scrum certified. Salaries range from around $94,000 to $164,000, and I've personally seen project managers go up to $300,000 as they land more senior roles. The next job on the list is a sales development representative, SDR. In the banking example, these SDRs, responsibility, will be to generate leads, educate the customers, and basically they want to sell the app. Key skills include strong communication as well as really strong sales skills. And you don't need to know any code, but you do have to have a strong knowledge of the technical product that you're selling. As for qualifications, there is no specific degree requirement, but you're going to want to get some sales experience like selling in a retail store as well as Salesforce, and there is a certification that you can get for it, and many companies do provide training for many SDR positions. And for salary, it ranges from around $89,000 to $155,000, and the pay structure for these roles usually have a base pay with commission. So if you perform really well, there is no cap to how much more you can make. And the next job on our list is the most technical, which is a solutions architect. What does a solutions architect do? Imagine the company wants to build an analytics platform. The solutions architect will meet with the company to understand their business requirements. They will then teach you how you can build a solution to ingest the data and analyze it. They will also ensure security and basically help the business throughout the implementation phase of developing this analytics platform. Having coding experience helps, but it isn't required. A solutions architect should have really strong cloud platform knowledge, such as AWS, Azure, and Google Cloud. They also have really strong database and security knowledge and are extremely customer focused. There isn't a specific degree requirement, but you want to have hands-on experience using cloud tools and get certifications such as the AWS certification or Microsoft to showcase that you have cloud technology skills. And the salaries range from around $147,000 to $218,000. And as the demand for cloud technology increases, the demand for this role will go up as well. Please like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video, and let me know in the comments which of these data roles you're interested in. I will also link my next video on data roles specifically that are high paying, and I can't wait to see you there. Thank you so much.